In this video, we'll use double angle identities to simplify and then evaluate the following expressions. So the first expression is cosine squared pi divided by 12 minus sine squared of pi divided by 12, which fits the form of this first identity. Notice on the right side we have cosine squared a minus sine squared a is equal to cosine of 2a. So for the first expression, a is equal to pi over 12. So we can rewrite this as cosine of 2a, or cosine of 2 times pi over 12. Put the 2 over 1, this simplifies. So we have a cosine pi over 6, which is a 30 degree angle. Let's go ahead and sketch our reference triangle. And the cosine of 30 degrees is square root 3 divided by 2. For the second expression, we have 2 cosine of pi over 4 times cosine pi over 4, which fits this double angle identity for sine. Notice we have 2 sine a cosine a on the right side, which is equal to sine of 2a. So a is equal to pi over 4. So this is equal to sine of 2a, or 2 times pi over 4. Again, this simplifies nicely. So this equals sine of pi over 2, which is equal to 1. And we can verify this if we need to on the unit circle. Here's pi over 2 radians. On the unit circle, sine theta is equal to y. So sine pi over 2 is equal to 1. In our last example, we have 2 cosine squared pi over 2 minus 1, which fits the form of this identity here, where a is equal to pi over 2. And so this right side is equal to cosine of 2 times a. So we have cosine of 2 times pi over 2 is just going to be pi. And cosine of pi is equal to negative 1. And again, if we need to, we can verify this on the unit circle. Here's the terminal side of pi radians. Cosine theta is equal to x. So we have a cosine function value of negative 1.